look around, come around this way, and you can see where it's, yeah, see? And see little red light blinks. So whenever we get...
Well, I was born in a little town outside of Dallas, and I was brought up, I grew up in Dallas, Texas, and spent some time going back and forth to my grandparents that lived in Ennis, Texas. There, they were, I guess, worked the fields, and while I was living with them, I got to experience that, go out and work the cotton fields and get up early in the morning, and work was the most important thing, and that's what my grandparents really instilled in me. Work ethic, getting up early, doing a lot of work, eventually that was going to, very hard work would pay off.
I'm one of the countless artists who benefited from Sam's decades of selfless dedication to Austin's art community.
One of the most generous people I've ever had the pleasure to work with.
Thank you so much for all the years of hard work and sacrifice you've done for the love of the arts.
Thank you, Sam, for being a great mentor and leader, for believing in me, for being so real and humble, and for being so generous with your time, energy, and knowledge without ever asking anything in return.
You taught me that to survive in the borderlands, you must be stubbornly tenacious and believe in your work, even when no one else does. You were one of the hardest working and most selfless people I've known.
The source of numerous inquiries in my research, the gateway to a vast network of Latina y Latino artists.
As I mentioned before, when we were talking earlier, when I was in Houston back in the middle 70s, it was hard to get exhibits in established galleries or art centers. So as Chicanos, we had to create our own venues, either through restaurants, perhaps community centers in the barrio. We had to come up with ways to exhibit our work. And in those days, people would come out to see, especially Latinos in general, would come out to see because they were craving something different, something that would speak to them about the culture. And so I learned early on that there was an audience for our work, but it wasn't quite the audience I expected. So I learned a lot from that, and I realized that in time things would change, and they have. What I've been able to do is amass a lot of prints that I hope will be part of our legacy, our history. And where it's going to go, I'm hoping that more and more people are aware of what we're doing as Latinos here in the United States, and that we are part of that artistic fabric that binds everybody together here. And we have a voice, we have a say, and I think it's being heard more and more, and that's where our future is. More folks, more people learn about it, and not just in the United States, but all over the world. I think the more folks hear about it, the more success we'll find.
I am grateful for Sam being in my life, both as an art advocate and a friend, a treasure not only to the artists and the Chicano Latino arts community, but to anyone who met him, a positive force for good and community in a time when so many look to separate and exclude. He helped bring people together with dignity and pride in their culture.
Thank you, Sam Coronado, for telling our story through cultural activism.
Thanks, Sam, for paving the road for us younger Chicano printmakers and artists.
A legend and a pioneer when Latino art needed it most.
An amazing example to many of us younger Chicano and Chicana printmakers.
Friend, brother, mentor, activist, artist, trailblazer.
Thank you for your guidance, patience, sense of humor, and never-ending generosity. You had such a positive impact on so many artists' lives, especially mine. Working and laughing with you was a highlight in my life.
His legacy will live on for many, many years. He was always helping others. He gave and did so much for so many people.
You believed in me, treated me as a peer, and were always my friend. I owe you a great deal.
He was ever so gracious. Everyone who met him made a friend.
Filled with laughter, kindness, heartfelt words, encouragement, and camaraderie. One of my best friends, supporters, and I admired him so much. He was the most empathetic and compassionate mentor.
Here's to all the innovation you inspired.
A positive person during every moment I ever spent with him.
A mentor, a teacher, a friend.
So within the sphere of art, Chicano art, What do you feel is your best contribution to this date, Sam? Where do you feel that, you know, you had a moment to sit back and say, this is where I really made a difference in terms of leaving a legacy?
Yeah. Well, I wish I could say it was my art. maybe history will see one or two pieces that I could, mm-hmm. that possibly could be put in that context. But I think, looking back at what these past 20 years mean to me, I think that's the legacy that I feel strongly about, that I was able to bring artists together to do art under the auspices of the Serie project, and to be able to meet these artists, some artists that I didn't know anything about and others that I heard about and read about and had gotten to know. So I think that's probably right now is probably the legacy that I think I probably will live.
What do you see post Sam Coronado, so to speak, with because survival of something so important is important. Any comments on that?
I think the basis and the shell for our organization has all been already created. We just need to keep going to keep building on it. And the sky's the limit, really. There's really no reason why it couldn't go on as long as there was support for it, and as long as we continue doing something positive. I don't see it stopping.